just wanna dance, I feel good.
Hey guys, so today's video is a DIY organizational slash decor video for your desk. And since a lot of us are back to school, I wanted to do something that can kind of inspire you to actually want to be productive and do your schoolwork and actually spend time at your desk. Because for me, if I'm not inspired to do homework, I will put it off till the very last minute. So having a nice area to do my homework at really helps for me. So some of these ideas I found on Pinterest and others were just inspired by things I wanted to create or kind of personalize for myself. So I hope you guys will enjoy this. I'm actually in love with how these DIYs turned out. I'm so happy. And I think that a lot of them look like they aren't DIYs. Just a little pat on the back there. So if you enjoyed this video, then don't forget to give it a thumbs up so that I know you would like to see more videos like this in the future. And also, if you're not already, don't forget to subscribe so you can see whenever I post a new video. And yeah, without further ado, let's get right into it. So this first DIY is super easy. All I did was I started off by taking some Elmer's spray adhesive and sprayed a coat of it on the back of a clear desk pad that I picked up from IKEA for around $7. After that, you just want to take some wrapping paper of your choice and then lay it down with the pattern side facing the adhesive coating and then smooth it out over the back of the pad. And I actually realized after I was done making the DIY that I should have gone with a more brightly colored paper because it doesn't show through the IKEA pads as well as it does with other clear desk pads. After that, I trimmed off the edges of the paper once it was dry. This is seriously the easiest DIY ever, and you can totally personalize it to reflect your own personal style. I don't believe a single word you say that you're sorry. Why can't I say? So I absolutely love this next DIY, and again, you can totally personalize it however you'd like. So I started off by importing a picture I liked into PicMonkey and then added an inspirational word. Then I changed the shape of my image to a circle because the base I'm using for my mouse pad is a circle, and then I cropped the image into a perfect square and saved it. So to get it ready for printing, I flipped my image horizontally for my transfer paper and resized my image to 7¼ inches to fit my cork circle, and then I printed it out. So then I just cut my image out from my transfer paper and followed the instructions on the package. So I used a piece of an old cotton t-shirt for my fabric. You really need to press down hard and make sure you spend extra time on all the corners when you use transfer paper. Otherwise, it will not stick properly. So for the base of my mouse pads, I used these cork pot stands from IKEA, which were only a couple of dollars. So to make my mouse pad, I started off by tracing my cork onto a layer of cardstock so I would have an opaque base for my mouse pad. If you don't have access to these, you could use cork from like Michael's or a dollar store, or even just use an old foam mouse pad that you're not using anymore. So I just used Mod Podge and a foam brush to glue down my layers, starting with my cardstock and then smoothing that out and doing another layer of the Mod Podge, and then finally adding my fabric on top. And then after I let it dry for a little bit, I finished it off with another layer of Mod Podge and then let that dry again. To make my mouse pad fit with my gold theme a little bit better, I took some of this super amazing, can't believe I didn't own this before, metallic gold leaf from Michael's and started painting in the white letters. This took a little bit of time because I have the shakiest hands in the entire world, I swear, but it is totally worth it in my opinion. And you could totally stop here and just cut off the extra fabric if you don't mind the cork being exposed around the side. But I don't really love the look of cork, so I used some more of the Mod Podge around the edges of the fabric and some push pins to hold the fabric in place while it dried. And then after that, I cut off the fabric and added another piece of cardstock on the back to make it look a little bit more finished, which I know is totally extra, but you could totally simplify this and make this a much faster process than mine was. So this next DIY was actually inspired by a memo board that I saw at Target, and I love how this came out. For the base of the board, I just used a cork board that I got at the dollar store, and then in small sections, I started applying hot glue to the frame of the board and then pressed down a layer of cotton. Then after I was done gluing down the cotton, I thinned it out so you could just barely see the cork through it. So after that, I trimmed off the extra cotton, but left just enough around the edge to cover the sides of the board. And then I laid my board down on the fabric with the cotton side facing down down and trimmed off the extra fabric. So the material that I used was cross-stitch fabric that I got at Michael's, but you could easily use like burlap or linen or anything you really like, just so long as it's strong enough to hold push pins. Then to attach the fabric to the board, I folded it over the back and used a stapler to attach it along the back of the frame. And for the corners, I just stapled all the way along the sides of the board until I was left with these little triangle flaps, and then I stapled those down as well. For the ribbon, I took it and laid it down diagonally over the board and then cut it so that there were a few extra inches on each side to wrap around to the back. And then I attached it to the board with some sewing pins. Then I measured 2¾ inches away from the middle ribbon and made a mark with some pins. And from there, I started attaching the rest of my ribbons on. And 2¾ inches was the size that worked nicely for my corkboard. But depending on the size of your board, you might want to use bigger or smaller gaps. Then after I was done that, I went ahead and did the exact same thing, going the opposite direction to form little diamonds with the ribbon. Then to finish off the ribbon, I just flipped the board over and glued each piece down, making sure that they were secured tightly to the board, and then I just cut off any of the excess ribbon. Then for a final touch for the pin board, I wanted to add some gold pieces to go with the rest of my theme. So I painted the fronts and backs of two different sized buttons with some more of the gold leaf. And then after letting them dry, I went ahead and attached them to my board with some hot glue, just where the ribbons intersected. So I got inspiration for this next idea from a DIY Christmas gift that I did last year. So to make this, I just used a glass candlestick holder that I got at the Dollar Tree for a dollar and a small glass jar. And then I used an industrial strength glue. So I just did a thin layer of the glue around the top of the candlestick holder and then put my jar on top and centered it. And then you just want to let that dry. In the meantime, I painted my lid gold to match my theme, and that's literally it. It takes less than 5 minutes, and you have a super cute jar to hold some small objects for your desk. You call me what you wanna, I ain't giving you a dollar. This time I ain't gonna run. The next idea isn't actually a DIY, but what I did is I searched weekly planner in Pinterest for some free printables. And I found one that I really liked, and then I went to the website and downloaded the two that I wanted to print out. So I printed out a bunch of copies of each one and then added them to some clipboards that I got at the dollar section of Target. I'm obsessed with these. I think they're super cute, and anything that makes me more organized is perfection to me. I'm 21. This last DIY is just a way to dress up some basic clothespins. So I took some Elmer's school glue and did a thin layer on the tops of some clothespins and then smoothed it out with a brush. And then I sprinkled on some gold leaf flakes that I got on Amazon. I also did this with some fine gold glitter and just brushed off any of the excess after they were dry. I also covered the backs of some of the clothespins with some sparkly gold washi tape and pressed the sides of the tape down. So I hope you guys enjoyed that. And yeah, I hope you guys are all doing well, and I will see you all in the next video. Bye guys.